Yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. I'm taking my hair out this weekend. I just can't do it. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. If it's your first time, if it's your first time in the neighborhood, before we do anything, we set the vibe. That's just how I feel right now. But this the vibe for today. I'm definitely not gonna be long because I'm literally in the middle of a ticket. I'm gonna take a little break because I always feel better after I record. So today is the Leo full moon, the wolf moon. So they be having me and my feelings all fucking every day of my life, bruh. Like,
The Bachelor is
sick
back.
Of this shit.
Streaming live on ABC with YouTube TV.
I already know it's the gates. We're gonna run a gate song.
Why stay inside the lines?
I don't know what
you
the fuck
could add
this
some
is.
Flavor to everything around you.
Yeah,
a little cheesy here. Crumbs are coming there.
Let's take my sweat shirt off because it's hot.
Hands on my face don't mean nothing. I was locked up. I don't mean nothing. When you make it through the struggle, it's in the being hustler. All the one of my life that kind of being hustler. I ain't too hard to tell you how I feel. When you said my name on it, made me know it's real. I ain't too hard to tell you how I feel. What you say you don't do, girl, you know I will. I'm just the realest that you ever met.
Yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Today is Thorough Thursday. It's Thorough fucking Thursday in this beach, in this bitch. All right, so if it's your first time in the neighborhood, please make sure, please check them for a YR earpiece. Please, please make sure you bring it back to the bottom of the map. Make sure you go all the way back to the very beginning and watch the very first video that I ever uploaded called Welcome to the Neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Like I said, it's the very first video I ever uploaded. It's a tinge awkward like me, but shit, you'll just lean into it. You'll get used to it. Watch from Welcome to the Neighborhood in chronological order until the point you came in on the journey. So, Welcome to the Neighborhood, which is the very first video uploaded, then the second video, then the third, then the fourth, then the fifth, then the sixth, all the way until the point you came in on the journey. What's the point you came in on the journey? I'm so glad you asked. The point you came in on the journey is the video that you clicked that introduced you to me, that made you say, who is this girl? The fuck is she talking about? Do I want to fucking listen to her? Do I want to thank you next, this hoe? That's the point you came in on a journey. And so you need to know if this is the first, if this is where you came in on a journey, you need a little bit of more instructions. You need to understand we follow two people here. One not actually been a person, more or less a spirit, and it's God. As for me and my house, I serve the Lord. And then second, we follow Uncle Luke. We don't stop. We pop that pussy. We keep going past the point we came in on the motherfucking journey. We watched it to the very last video that has been uploaded. I like to tell people that this is a story of a girl and God, and you get to watch wherever the fuck I'm going, whether it be to the White House, the whole house, or the Poe House. It might be all of those things in one day. It just depends. If you want to know a little bit about the channel and why I am doing what I'm doing, make sure you go and see a video called A Thing About Hope. The Thing About Hope. It's called The Thing About Hope. Not A Thing About Hope. So that part. All right. So I like, y'all know I like to record every day, but I really just having to sit my stupid ass down. I've been having to sit my stupid ass down. Everything is just like everything. That's the name of this video. Just little small things that really blow me. I gotta make another nail appointment. So Mercury retrograde. I need to get on my Mercury taught me. But so my weak ass. So with HelloFresh, you have to skip, when you sign up for HelloFresh, you have to put your card information in, and you have to skip the weeks that you don't want. So my intention was fully to skip this week, and I thought I had skipped this week, but I didn't. And so I go to my bank account, and it's just like, oh, yeah, you got a fucking HelloFresh box coming tomorrow, bitch. So I'm just like, whatever, God, just take the wheel. Whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do. HelloFresh, you should start incorporating desserts into your boxes. Where I grew up, you got to have a fucking dessert. So there's that. Ain't no desserts. The only thing, my only critique on HelloFresh is that you actually have to cook these meals, and they don't have like no fast meals, and that's the point of HelloFresh. But you gotta get up and cook. So when you don't feel like cooking, you don't feel like cooking, and it's true to size. So if it's it's two portions, it's two portions. So I have one for dinner and usually eat the other one for lunch, and so then I have to cook the next night. And sometimes I don't really fucking feel like fucking cooking, but that's not HelloFresh for problem, that's my problem. So there's that. I know y'all, like, I don't give a fuck if y'all tired of hearing about babe, but like, so last we talked, I think that's the last time I might have been talking about him, but like, I had a very growthful moment with him. So I saw something on the, and so it's so crazy because things just line up. So last night before I even saw this, like, I had to make an ego versus heart decision, and I made the heart decision. I felt like a puss ass nigga when I made the heart decision. And if I start crying, fuck this shit, cause I'm fucked up. He don't even know how fucked up he got me, but this nigga got my head gone, bitch. Gone, 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 gone. She gonna kill herself if I leave her. She know I don't play around. Like, I ain't gonna kill myself if he leave me, but bitch, we gonna fight before you go, you know? You know, but in the same sense, I say that jokingly, but I always, like, I don't hold too tight to anything. But all of that to say, so yesterday, I found out babe was mad with me. Bitch, I started crying. I started crying for a bunch of different reasons. But if there's one thing in this world I don't want, and it's I don't want him to, like, I don't ever want to make him mad at me. And so because this is a vlog mostly to myself, in the future, when Bae say he don't want to talk, just leave him alone. Just leave him alone. He come back around, but don't bother him no matter what it is, unless it's like a life or death thing. Just leave him alone. But, you know, contrary to that, you know, and you only you, Leanne, know what this is and this is about. But you did feel, you were right to feel the way you felt. But remember, there's a time and place for everything. And if your goal is to really make him happy and to be his peace, you really gotta pick and choose your battles. Which may not always make you feel the best at the time, but, you know, like, it's all about compromise. And so, with that being said, yesterday, I realized I was fucking, like, I always tell y'all I love baby, but no. There's a song in Beauty and the Beast that says, there is something there that wasn't there before. There is something there that wasn't there before. Bitch, I don't know how I got there. Bitch didn't ask for fucking permission to be there. I wasn't, that bitch creeped up on my ass like the Grim Reaper. Like, the fuck is going on? I'm crazy about this nigga. And I tell him that all the time. He'd be like, likewise. And he probably is, but I don't get to see him. So, like, he don't express his emotions like me. He's not a, you know, I'm a, you know, in your face type of person. He's a, like, I can tell, like, the way he talks to me and the way he touched me. Like, it just makes sense. You talk about love languages, his love language is touch. And I can tell by the way he talked to me or whatever. But I know he loved me. I don't know if he wants to or not, but he do. And this is a very scary place for me to be. Because I don't want to be here, partially. I want to be here, but I just got out of some fucked up shit. And so I have to cause myself not to self-sabotage because of what I've been through. And it's easy. And I started to, but I caught myself. But what I realized is I love that nigga. Like, I saw this, the new moon, the full moon. One that I was strolling through YouTube, and it says, Leo Moon, choose, follow your heart, not your ego. Bitch, let me tell you. I'm going to say this, and I mean this from the bottom of my motherfucking soul, and, like, I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with this nigga. I can't wait to see him and hug him and touch him and kiss him and fill up on him, like, all night. Like, I really can't. Like, it's not, I've been in a lot of relationships, but I ain't never felt, I did something else, you know, it's something there that wasn't there before. So, I'm in my feelings about that, and I really realized that, you know, I love him for real, for real. Like, I love him. I knew I loved him, but it's a different type of thing. I can't explain it. It ain't no words for it. But, like, that song Power, he got that power over me. Like, he got the power to hurt me. You know what I'm saying? So, that shit gets scary, you know. And you have to ask yourself, is it a risk that you're willing to take? And it most certainly is. For him, I'd take that bitch. It was one other person that I remember saying that I'd risk hell for. I knew that it wasn't love. I just thought you fuck with me. And that wasn't love. Like, I've been writing my vows, nigga. Like, for real, for real, for real. Like, it's different. Like, I met, like, and a part of my vows is just, like, I met people who pretended to be you. But once I felt your essence, like, it was something that it couldn't be duplicated. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's a lot of people, it's a lot of men in my life that dated me, that wanted me to be their soulmate. I don't believe in all of that shit. Like, I believe in it, but to a certain extent. But, like, they wanted me to be their person. They wanted me to be their match. But, like, and they convinced me of it until, like, I realized that it wasn't that. And, like, you ain't ever have to convince me of nothing. You ain't never tried to convince me. You never really gave a fuck. And me neither. You don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck neither. But some kind of way, like, you can tell it by its essence, by the way it walked, the way it talked, the way it moved. And so, like, I just think about, like, I really feel like this nigga, I'm not going to give the vials away, but I can't wait to say them to him, if that makes sense. And so that got me in such a melancholy tone, because I'm petrified, because it's just like, you know, that's a big leap to take. But all of that, on a real note, like, I say this, like, dreams come true. You just gotta wait on it and really say no to what you don't want, even if it kind of look like what you want. Like, just say no to it when you know what you deserve. I deserve him. I thought I deserved some other guys, but I didn't deserve those guys, because those guys weren't, for lack of better terms, they weren't him. And I don't say that to compare people to him, but it's just something that I can't really explain. Thorough Thursday is really sitting with yourself and chilling with your demons. And right now, my demons is like, who, bitch, you gonna need something stronger than turmeric milk, bitch. So there's that. All right, so on top of that, so Bay is running rampant in my mind, and the only thing, like Beyonce said, the only remedy is the poison, is the thing that poisoned me. You meet a kindred spirit like that, it's crazy. I can't explain it to you, but the only thing that's gonna cure it is just like to have him touch me, just to like touch him, just to grab him, and just, he don't know I ain't letting him go. When he get here, I'm not, like, he think he going back home, but he not, he at home. And it be like that. So there's that. So that's the first part of Thursday, Thorough Thursday, my little confessional to myself. Like, nah, like, I don't let you go too many times. I don't let you out my grass too many times. I can't. And I don't know if you feel like that about me, but I feel like that about him. And even if he never feel that way about me, ladies, like, to have felt this, like, and he a clean person. This ain't no nigga that I ain't gotta wonder, but he a clean, like, his heart clean. Like, it is. Like, it ain't no guessing. Like, when he told me he was mad at me, like, man, ain't nothing hurt my feelings. Like, I was hurt because I hurt him. And that's how I feel like you really know that's how you really know it's love. Like, I'm not going to do nothing to hurt you, because when you hurt, I hurt. Like, for real, for real. Like, if I hurt you, and I, like, the moment I realize I hurt you, I can't fucking function. You know what I'm saying? I don't ever want to hurt that nigga. That's, like, but, you know, I just appreciate him as a human. And I think he deserved the world. And I know he think I deserve the world. So God say the same. We get the world together. We experience and we travel. And we have the world together. Or we our worlds coincide, collide. And we have a good time along the way, you know, to this journey of death, to death, you know. So, but I don't want to ever, like, when I see him, I'm going to squeeze him so tight. And just kiss him and just tell him how much I love him. So that Thorough Thursday. Also, really quickly, I want to talk about a lot of things, but I have so many things to do today, and I have a smaller, like, my tolerance grows, and I don't know, like, I talked to him, I was in a cool mood, just fantasizing, and then he told me he was mad at me, and I'm still trying to pull myself out of that funk of being disappointed in myself for upsetting him. I can't be too hard on myself, and I know our relationship not gonna be perfect, but I don't ever want to fight with him. Cause I don't like confrontation at all, but I don't ever want to make him mad. And I know that's not realistic. I know it's gonna happen, but just know I'm salty when it happens. And I know it gotta happen, cause I gotta set boundaries too. And that's gonna, you know, push. That's gonna cause some pushback. But at the end of the day, I just always want to see a smile on that fool ass nigga face. I don't care what it is. So there's that. I'm fuck it. Like, I'm getting out my feelings with this shit. This is my fucking vlog, and this is what y'all get. Like, I hope y'all find somebody who make you feel. Like, I'm usually the one making people feel. This nigga made me feel. I ain't never had no shit. It's something different. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the difference between this relationship and any other one I ever had. It's just like, I'm usually like, I'm not doing like, this nigga make me feel. I'm a lot. And it ain't a lot of people that make me feel. It's just not. And I feel, oh my God, I feel everything. Stop. So I wanted to talk really quickly about colorism. People talk about, like, I don't know. As growing up, I got picked on. They used to call me Lee Monkey. E-E-I-I, bitch. Like, I don't give a fuck. Like, I don't know. I feel like, an unpopular opinion, people make too much of a fucking... Like, deal out of that shit. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck if you like black women or dark women or... Me and my baby gonna have some chocolate babies. Like, that nigga chocolate, and I'm chocolate. He say, I bet you taste good, too, dude. Like, I'm not, like, they got on Danny Lee or whatever her name is. The baby fine as fuck, too. But, like, they got on Danny Lee because she made a bad yellow bone. First, all of you motherfuckers, get you some lifes. Bitch, they don't sell it. Walmart, motherfucker, you could buy a video game. Ain't GameStop got some shit going on? I'm sure they got some fucking lights for sale. Get you a fucking life. Like, listen, it is what it is. The colorism exists. Like, brown paper bag test. Everything in this thing is exacerbated. Like, get the fuck over it. Like, I feel like only ugly, dark-skinned bitches got a problem with light-skinned bitches. Like, yeah. Cause it's some ugly, you ain't never seen an ugly light-skinned bitch. Like, have you? Cause I feel like I know a couple ugly light-skinned bitches. Like, I don't think the problem is with the people. The problem is with the attitude that the people with the dark skin got. I can say that cause I used to have low self-esteem. But bitch, you can't tell me nothing. Can't tell me nothing. Tell me I'm ugly. Bitch, I'll fuck your man in front of you. And I wouldn't do that because babe was like, no. But I'll fuck you. And make your man watch while babe fuck you. We don't give a fuck if you light skin, dark skin, white, yellow, black, white. We don't give a fuck. Like J. Cole say, the pussy all pink on the inside. Fuck what color they face is. Wise words from an indecent man. But like, yeah, like I understand colorism and all that shit. Like, when we don't have enough dark skin black faces out in the, and don't get it twisted. I love the King of Reese. I like his energy. I watch him for pure entertainment. But and I know it's just a conversation piece, but how I feel about it is get the fuck over it. You dark skinned and you want to see more dark skinned people. Then put yourself fucking out there. People gonna talk about you whether you doing bad or good, baby. You really want to be a fucking influencer? You really want the world to change? Then fucking change it. Stop talking about it. The more you talk about it, get the fuck over it. Get the fuck over it. Like, and people gonna be like, well, she said get the... Bitch, I'm a dark-skinned bitch. But I look great. And, like, I look great with blonde hair, bitch. I look great with black hair, bitch. I look great with orange and pink hair, bitch. I look great in the motherfucking ballroom, bitch. I look great on a motherfucking boat, bitch. I look great. And I got some badass yellow bones that's great. I got some badass red bones. And so I think the only thing that perpetuates the colorism is the continual conversation for a need for the conversation of colorism. Like, we're keeping that shit alive. We don't talk about that shit. You ever heard out of sight, out of mind? We don't talk about that shit. Like dark-skinned people have the same rights as light-skinned people. And then, like Jay-Z say, and we still niggas. And I ain't black, I'm OJ. Bitch, I'm OJ. Fuck this shit. I'm not black, I'm OJ. Like, that's the thing. Like, at the end of the day, whether you fucking the color of a motherfucking paper bag or you the color of fucking charcoal, bitch, you still a nigga. And then at the end of the day, if we really want to get down to really make all of this shit motherfucking make no sense, put a blindfold on the motherfucker. Cut a person from every race. And then tell that person with the blindfold to pick the color, pick the race contingent on the blood. Tell me which one of these is nigga blood. I'll wait. That's how you get rid of colorism and racism. But I'm not joining in the conversation of badgering people or picking on people because she wanna. If the baby wanna bad yellow bone, the bitch say she yellow bone, then let the bitch be yellow bone. If the bitch wanna be a motherfucking Smurf. It's bitches out here dressing up like Smurfs. And y'all mad at this bitch because her skin yellow? Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. I don't have it. I don't fucking have it for the humans right now. I don't have it for the fucking human race. I don't. Like, it's real life bitches that like to dress up like bunnies and get fucked. It's real life niggas that like to fuck fucking anything, bitch. Anything that move. And you worry about this bitch calling herself a bad yellow bone. Go get you some business. Go get you some business. Please. Please go get you some motherfucking business. Y'all mad at this woman because of what? Go get you some motherfucking business. Please. Because I don't have fucking time for this shit. Let's talk about something that motherfucking matter. Like, what the fuck is going on with Robin Hood? And do I need to move my fucking investments? That's the real motherfucking question. You worry about if this bitch yellow or not? That bitch could call herself a doe. He like does instead of hoes, bitch. I don't give a fuck. Like. But, again, maybe that's just me. You're minimizing. You're not taking it seriously. I'm not. I'm really not. Fight me, bitch. Come fight me, ho. Like this shit's stupid. This shit's stupid. Stupid. Don't be stupid like them hoes. Alright, so that's my little rant on that. Like, it's not enough. Like, bitch, I'm a dark skin, whatever. And I'm all like, when I say I'm all natural, like, first off, I hate when people be like, I can't stand people who say that they're natural, but they got motherfucking extensions and eyelashes. Bitch, get you some business and use some lives, bitch. Like, I don't wear makeup. Y'all don't ever see me face beat. You see the marks on my skin. Bitch, you see, like, y'all seen this little mark up here. Sometimes my hair be done, sometimes it don't. Like, I don't. So, but if your thing is fucking getting dressed up, fucking get dressed up. I don't give a fuck. It's your life. This be my problem. And then I'm going to go to my little Thorough Thursday rant. This be my problem with people. People be like with Kevin Hart with his, like, whatever video he just came, no fucks given. No, you gave a fuck, Kevin. We talked about this before. You gave a fuck. Because if you didn't really give a fuck, you wouldn't have gave a fuck. Fuck what people got to fucking say. Everybody want to cancel me, bitch, then you're going to be bored. What the fuck are you going to watch if you cancel me then, bitch? This person don't know. No, bitch, I just got an opinion. Cancel me. My little niece was saying that. I'm thinking I cancel you. Cancel this dick, bitch. Cancel that shit. Cancel these nuts, hoe. Like, Danielle, you made the song, bitch. Like me, like Nene Nick said, bitch, I said what I said. You disagree, you're entitled to disagree. You don't, everybody in the world could fucking disagree with me. But if I say I'm a fucking blue Smurf, bitch, I'm a blue Smurf. You ain't gotta believe I'm a blue Smurf. I don't really give a fuck. DJ Khaled, in one of his videos, he's the one with Bernice Burgess in it. He was like, my name is Billy now. And he just started calling her Billy. And he did that to just show people don't, these hoes don't give a fuck. They gonna call you whatever they call. Call me what you want, bitch. Just don't call me for free. I don't give a fuck. For the right amount of money. Everybody will shut the fuck up and call Danny Lee a yellow bone. And so my thing is for these motherfucking, for these ladies and these gentlemen and all these people who really talking about that shit, get you some motherfucking guts. Bitch, I said what I said. I'm sorry. No, bitch, I'm not. And then your apologies come off as insincere because you're not sorry. Because if you were sorry, then you wouldn't have done it. Like Kevin Gates saying I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry. When I'm sorry, I mean I'm sorry. But I'm not sorry. Like, I mean what I said, bitch. I will make the baby eat my pussy with a grill that said yellow and bone at yellow, yellow, bitch, with Y-E-L-L-A, yellow, and then bone with a fucking dog bone at the bottom. I'll take a picture of him biting my pussy with that shit. With rose gold, bitch, yellow bone, bitch. If you gonna do it, do it. That's the problem. Like, that's why nothing changed. Everybody got that. They hesitate. One of my exes told me that when you hesitate, that's when you get murked. Don't hesitate, bitch. No, I said what I said. I said what I said. And I meant that shit. But the problem is, people don't be meaning that shit. People just be wanting to be like, I don't give a fuck if you like me, bitch. I like me. Every day of the week. And let me tell you, some days I don't like me. Like yesterday, I was so salty with myself because I made baby mad. Which I probably, like, I go back and forth with, but I made my baby mad. I don't ever want to make my baby. I don't ever want to make Zaddy mad. I'm sorry. Like, I promise you I'd never do that shit again. Like, I mean it. I'm not. Not to him, anyways. Like, no, I'm sorry. I'm not. Like, and it's so funny because, like, so many people wish that I would just, nah, for him, nah, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm not gonna ever do that again. I ain't even argue with him. I'm sorry. All I could say was, I'm sorry. Like, I'm sorry. I ain't argue. I ain't fuss. I'm sorry. You need anything? You want me to run the Baton Rouge and suck your dick? You know, Mercury got me in the motherfucking chokehold like this, bitches. Like, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up, bitch. Don't say nothing. That's how Mercury got me. Like, if Mercury taught me anything, it's just to shut the fuck up. And I'm shutting the shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. I'm shutting the fuck up. I don't really got nothing to talk about. I ain't really talking to nobody. We ain't really got to have no conversation. If it ain't about business, we ain't really got nothing to talk about. All right, I'm at 32 minutes. I definitely need to run. Let me tell y'all, bitch. I know I'm about to be hot. I got a fucking PowerPoint to have out by tonight. We got a meeting about that bitch in the motherfucking morning. I got my meeting in the morning. I'm taking my motherfucking hair out. I got motherfucking book club coming up. Then I got these interviews tomorrow. I got like 3 meetings tomorrow. Then I got these interviews to do. And I need to figure out if I can get this background. Like, all before Bay come. I'm over. But I'm gonna get it done. I'm gonna work my little ass off. And then I'm gonna disappear. And then come back. I'm trying to get my mind right for Bay. I don't know. Like. But. Mercury really just taught me security. Mercury really has just been teaching me the art of being quiet and not impulsive and not popping off on nobody and how to respond and really not react. And it showed me how much I love Ashton. Like, a lot. And I told you it crept up on me like TLC. So I creeped. Yeah, that shit creeped. Creeped up on a bitch. And I could fight it or I could just lean into it. I'm going to just lean into it. I'm going to be water and go with the fucking flow. But I'm still in my feelings. Learning to be open again is really, really, really hard after you come out of something, but you really gotta ask yourself. Shout out to fucking CEO, Corey Brown. shout out to him for just being a good coach. Like, I'm still in the gym every day. The mantra is still do it on the dick, but I just be quiet. And so, like, if I'm off a little bit, if I'm off a little bit, or I don't say too much, or I'm really recalibrating my spirit, because I really am creating the life I want, and I'm fighting demons as I create the life I want. Because it's like, the closer you get to your dreams, the harder whatever battle that it is that you need to battle gets. And I guess, like, I'm so close, I'm almost there, but it's hard. Like, I don't want to stand in my own way, and we can tend to do that sometimes. And so I think, if anything, I could say, you know, Thorough Thursday Mercury taught me is don't stand in your own way. And there will be moments, and there will be times where you feel like you're starting to stand in your way. You got to really check yourself. I always use Mercury retrograde as a time of reflection. And I want to be, like, I want to be the best wife in the world for Ash. I really do. Like, I really do. I want to be the pretty, dainty, little, like, baby doll that he could do whatever he want with. I really, really do. But before I can do that for him, I really got to get myself together. So I'm just really spending some time working on myself, working on creating the life I want for us. So if I'm not, you know, you won't get videos back to back to back right now. That's because I'm just my spirit. Like, don't record, because you don't really have nothing to say. I needed to record today because I had to get this out of my spirit. I'd be so scared. I don't want to lose that one. You know what I'm saying? And I hope he feel the same way about me. But one minute, 1 second, one day, 1 hour, 1 minute, sometimes 1 second at a time. And so that's where I'm at right now. This guy, you already know your will be done. You know, I can want it one way and you call it another one, but I think me and you on the same page as per this one. We'll see though. I'll let y'all know. But I think we got one. We just gonna see though. My heart's so full and so happy. I'm so in love, and I ain't never think I'd find nothing like this. I ain't never think I'd run across nothing like this, especially with my ex just leaving me the way he did. But they say when God, he won't close one door without opening another one. And if this the door, I feel unworthy. But one day at a time, guys. So I just want to hop on and do a quick Thorough Thursday with you guys. I gotta run because y'all already know work calling, but I'm grateful. Oh man, I'm grateful, and I'm petrified for all the things to come. So today on this, you know, tonight on this moon, this might be an emotional moon for you. It's been emotional for me. I just been crying. I've cried tears of joy. I cried tears of sadness. I cried just a release, and just knowing that I'm okay, and knowing that, you know, I'm out of the storm, and knowing that everybody not gonna hurt me, and knowing that there are good people in the world, and that God really is, like, he give you little breadcrumbs to keep going, and he keeps sending them my way. And so I'm so blessed. I'm making wonderful friendships, like real friendships. And so I'm grateful. Blessed. Late in the midnight hour. You already know. So that part, let me see what these folks talking about. Let me run. But don't make colorism a thing. Don't do that at all. Don't stand in your own way. Be open to even after you've been hurt, be open to love whenever you're ready. And sometimes it just creep up on you when you had no idea out of nowhere. And you thought you knew, but then you really find out. You know what I'm saying? It's a beautiful thing, but don't get it twisted. It's also hard and a lot of work too. Corey told me today that, you know, most of the gyms come in a waiting room, and he really helped me in understanding, like, this can only make us stronger, this can only make us better. But I don't, when you love somebody, you don't ever want to hurt them. That's how I know what I had before wasn't love, because I don't, like, when he told me I made him mad, like, when you meet good people, and I told Corey this too, when you meet good people, like, you don't want to make them mad, you don't want to get on their bad side. You don't ever want to upset them, because you be like, what did I do to make, you know, this person upset? You know what I'm saying? And you automatically want to remedy it. If you really care about these people. And it's so crazy, because, like, I don't know, but I know he done made me mad before. But I ain't never really make him mad. And so that's the thing too. Like we had fights, but I didn't know he was mad at me, but like, I don't ever want that. You know what I'm saying? So I just realized how much I love him. I knew I loved him already, but I was just like, oh, damn, this is, like I said, there's something there that wasn't there before. And so I just pray that did God cover our relationship, if this is what it's supposed to be. Check yourself before you could give yourself to anybody. Ladies and gentlemen, you gotta be whole. Like, I want to be a whole, I'm already a whole person, but it's still, like I tell you all the time, it's just little pieces of poison that I think are gone that aren't gone, that I have to really get out of myself. So there's that. I'm getting myself together so that when I see him and I squeeze him, like, he know I love him and he ready for it. I'm ready to give him what he deserves, and hopefully vice versa. But, you know, this is what Thorough Thursday was today. This is what Mercury taught me. So shut the fuck up, sit the fuck down, shut the fuck up, sit the fuck down, shut the fuck up and sit the fuck down. And just be observant and don't be impulsive. So that's where I'm at. I'm gonna take y'all out on fucking the Beauty and the Beast song, bitch. Cause that's how I feel. Cause that's how a bitch feel today. You go from Kevin Gates to fucking Beauty and the Beast, bitch. And then I'm gonna hop back on this work, but tell us all this time. And it's so funny, it's like plot twist. I think I would be the Beast. I don't know. I always tell them, I don't know who worries me or you, and I don't ever want to find out. Ever. Ever, ever. Not ever in this life. There we go. Celine Dion and Peebo Bryson. We definitely dancing to this at my way.
Walking around,
and everybody stiff, gonna turn
shoes is like pitching in a
I'm suit. Already planning the way. For real.
Not good. That's why I wear Skechers Stretch Fit. They contour and stretch to my feet for an ultra comfortable perfect fit.
Get Skechers some Stretch contour Fit. And stretch foot. Y'all have a blessed day. Happy Thorough Thursday. Go get it, because if you don't, you already know somebody fucking else will. Is it going to run for me?
Just a little change. Small to say the least, all the little scared, neither one with me. You deserve all these.
Lonnie, you were wrong. I told somebody, listen, I ain't never been on this side of wrong before. But I'm certain as the sun rising in the east. I'm certain. I hope y'all enjoyed this vibe. I hope y'all have a blessed day. Listen, believe in love. It's a real thing. It's really good people out there, and it's really that fairy tale love out there. You just gotta be willing to wait for it and really go get it and know you fucking deserve it.